Are you awake? Are you awake? Are you awake? Are you? You. You awake, awake, awake. 你醒了吗？Are you awake？句尾用升调。Are you awake？我们在读这句话的时候，you 和 awake 连读。You awake, you awake, you awake. Are you awake? Are you awake? 那么这里的 k 失去爆破。Are you awake? Are you awake?Are you awake? 比如你要和你的小伙伴早上去看日出啊，需要起得早。可是呢，你的小伙伴睡过头了，你着急啊，着急去找他，拍大门：“Hi，你醒了吗？”“Hello, are you awake?”Hello, are you awake? 啊，声音就比较大了，是吧？句尾呢用升调。Hello, 这个时候你再喊他。Hello, 升调。Are you? 后面有个连读。Awake, are you awake? Hello, are you awake?Hello, are you awake? 早上醒来的时候呢，你想要唤醒宝贝，这个时候呢，你的声音是温柔的。Honey, are you awake? Honey, 啊，这个时候轻轻的。Are you awake? 同样道理。You 和 awake 连读，句尾的 k 失去爆破，然后呢用声调。Honey, are you awake? Honey, are you awake? Honey, are you awake? 好，那么我们和爱人之间的对话呢，有的时候。啊，早上的时候呢，可以说一会儿话。那这个时候呢，你就可以问：“你醒了吗？”Are you awake？Are 在这里面可以弱读为 are。Are you 后面连读 awake？Are you awake？这里的 k 失去爆破。那对方告诉你，当然我醒了。他可以说 ，Of course I'm awake。哎 ，Of course， 这里的 s 和 I'm 连读为 sim。和 awake 可以连读为 awake。好，句尾呢 ，k 失去爆破。Of course I'm awake。Of course I'm awake. Are you awake? Of course I'm awake. Are you awake? Of course I'm awake. 西蒙，你醒了吗？啊，比如有个小男孩的弟弟叫西蒙。 那这个时候呢，他可以去唤西蒙。西蒙，你醒了吗？Simon, are you awake? Simon, are you awake? You 和 awake 连读。Awake 这里的 k 失去爆破，句尾呢用升调。Simon, are you awake? Simon, are you awake? Simon, are you awake? Now your turn. 现在该你了。Are you awake?Hello, are you awake? Honey, are you awake? Are you awake? Of course I'm awake. Simon, are you awake? Once more. Are you awake?Hello, are you awake? Honey, are you awake? Are you awake? Of course I'm awake. Simon, are you awake? Are you awake? Hello, are you awake?Honey, are you awake? Are you awake? Of course I'm awake. Simon, are you awake?
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe. See you.